Stoichiometry is the science of measuring quantitative chemistry using dimensional analysis to cancel units. The best thing about stoichiometry is that you can solve any stoichiometry problems using stoichiometry flowchart given to us here. If we look at the flowchart, it is divided into psi A and psi B. So this is psi A, this is psi B. The A and B represent two different chemicals. For instance, we have water itself, H2O, has two different chemicals in it. We have hydrogen and oxygen. Or it could just be one chemical if we're just looking at water by itself. Now, because A and B are on the same flowchart, you can convert the quantity of A to a quantity of chemical B. To memorize the whole entire flowchart, you just have to memorize psi A. Psi A and psi B are the same, except the chemical A's is changed to chemical B. So here you see all the A's change to B, like most A change to most B. So how do you use this flowchart? You start from your given unit based on your problems, and follow the flowchart until you get to the unit that you are looking for by multiplying conversion factors that are represented by arrows. So these are arrows of conversion factors that we see here, okay? This is one single arrow, this is also one single arrow. So each arrow represents one conversion factors. When memorizing your flowchart, there are key things that you have to pay attention to. Because psi A's and psi B's are the same. The first thing you have to know is that there are four possible units. In this case, the first one is mass of A's, it's going to be in terms of grams. Then we have moles of A's, it's going to be in terms of moles. Then we have volumes of A's, it's going to be in terms of liters. So focus on the unit that it is in. The last unit that you have to worry about is the represented particles A. Now, represented particle thing is representing a particles, or in this case, representing the type of particles. We have representative particles in terms of molecules. Basically, these particles are covalent compounds. Then we have represented particles in atoms. These are particles in atoms, like we have hydrogen itself, carbon, nitrogen. Those are in atoms, okay? And then we have ions. These are atoms with a positive or the negative charge. Or we have polyatomic ions with a positive and negative charge. Lastly, we have formula unit. Formula unit is to represent a particle that are ionic bonds. Now, those are the four major units that you have to know. The rest is the three conversion factors that relate the units together. In this case, going from mass A is going to be 1 moles of A equal to the number of grams of A. That number of grams is the molar mass of whatever the substance is. Now going down here, from moles A to the liters of volumes, we have 1 moles of A equal to 22.4 liters of A. This only possible at STP, standard temperature pressure. What is the standard temperature? It is going to be 0 Celsius. What is the standard pressure? It's going to be 1 atmosphere or 1 atm. So this only possible when it is at STP. Now if you want to convert from moles to represented particles, you will be using 1 moles of A equal to exactly 6.023 represented particles A. Now this 6 times 10 to 23rd is not just a random number. Now this number, 6 times 10 to the 23rd represented particles, is not a random number. It's a number that is determined by using carbon-12 and exactly 12 grams of carbon-12. And they figured out that in 12 grams of carbon-12, we have exactly 6 times 10 to the 23rd represented particles, or in this case, atoms of carbon-12. So This number is also known as the Avogadro number for the scientists who determined this number. So Avogadro number is basically referred to 6 times 10 to the 23rd.